So it's a fact that Facebook ads can be very profitable for your business, but it's also a way to lose a lot of money if you don't do it right. What I mean is this. There's a lot of courses out there on ads, but they assume that you know how to set up the Facebook pixel and implement the tracking within your funnel. Now, the reality is that there are standard events that track certain steps throughout your funnel. And by implementing those first and foremost before you even set up your ads, you will get a better idea of what is actually working in your funnel. So in other words, what most people do is they simply place the same pixel on all of the pages throughout the funnel. If you do that, it's not going to do you any good because you're not going to know what is actually happening throughout your funnel. In short, how do you know when somebody visits your site, your shopping cart, or when they make a purchase? Maybe somebody went to your site and didn't make a purchase. How do you track that? How do you track when somebody becomes a lead? Or perhaps they visited, but they don't purchase right away, and you want to retarget them and show ads to them to try to get them back to the sales page and purchase. And how do you make those types of ads to retarget those people? Without the proper pixel tracking in place, you would not know. That's the harsh reality. And this is why most people lose a lot of money when it comes to paid traffic. So this is a 9-part step-by-step video course, which is going to show you how to implement your Facebook ad tracking first so that you get good results with Facebook ads. So in this video course, you're going to be able to watch over my shoulder step-by-step, click-by-click, and learn what you need to do to install your Facebook ad tracking properly. So here's a quick video's overview of what's inside this video course. Video number one is the introduction to Facebook tracking. We'll talk briefly about this, why it's important, and what you need to have to get started. Video number two, we'll talk about Business Manager and why you need that and how to go about setting that up. Video number three, we'll talk about how to go about creating your Facebook pixel and why you should have different pixels if you have different products. And we'll go into that in terms of how many pixels you'll need and more. Video number four, we'll talk about standard events overview. So giving you a brief idea of what standard events are, why you need them, and how you can place them. And of course, video number five through video number eight will give you some practical real life application. So in video number five, we'll look at a specific funnel, which is the email opt-in funnel, and also known as the lead magnet funnel. And basically this funnel allows you to get somebody to go to a page, fill out their name and email in exchange for something free. So we're going to give you real life examples. We're going to show you where to install the code, how to go about creating the right code and all of that. So you will not get lost. Video number six, we'll talk about the abandoned cart funnel and what standard events you'll need and what that will look like. In video number seven, we'll talk about the purchase funnel, which is one step further from the abandoned cart funnel. And we'll do a deep dive into after they make the purchase, maybe you want to offer them a one-time offer or an upsell. And how do you go about tracking that information? And of course, video number eight, we'll talk about the lead form funnel, which is great for coaches, consultants, and service-based businesses that want to gather leads. And of course, last but not least, once you've installed your pixel, you want to make sure that you test it and make sure that it works. So that's what we talk about in video number nine. So go ahead and grab this video course today and begin setting up your Facebook ad pixel tracking the right way.